everybody. Thanks for coming to our foraging workshop. Today we're going to wade out into this lovely cold water, and we're going to be looking for different types of edible seaweed. Right around here in New England and in the States in particular, there's 10 edible and commercially viable seaweeds. So we call them the Gulf of Maine 10. And we like to make sure that people know how to collect these species, identify them properly, and do it sustainably. One of the ways that we were trying to promote these was you can go forage right in your own back sea garden, right? And people get very excited, but also kind of tentative. They say, wait, what? I can eat this? And how do I know I can eat this? They don't realize that they actually eat seaweed in almost anything that they actually put in their mouths from the grocery store. So it's in everything from ice cream to yogurt to toothpaste.
This is Irish moss here. And this is used a lot to make puddings and thickeners and things like that.
What's amazing about seaweeds is that they are chock full of pretty much every vitamin, micronutrient, mineral that you can think of that is good for your body. You can use this raw, just on top of soups and salads.
When I came into the university and to the marine bio program, I originally stated that I was just like, I don't want to do plants and I don't want to do anything with plant work because I think that's just awful. And here I am wanting to work with seaweeds. The internship definitely helped me know what I could do learning about seaweeds. Hands-on definitely was a lot better than just reading about it. Originally, a lot of it I thought would just be, oh, it's sushi, oh, it's related to sushi, and hearing that you can do a variety of different things. They're pretty much just like vegetables, so however you want to use a vegetable, you can use it with seaweed.
Get enough of that to line the bottom of the pot, and then throw your lobster on top of that.
Awesome.
One of the challenges or barriers, I suppose, for trying to develop this industry in New Hampshire is, okay, so if we grow it, who will buy it? Part of what Extension and New Hampshire Sea Grant try to do is to engage the community. We give the most up-to-date research going on in this. Part of my job is also to help keep our local seafood local, so we've established some relationships with local restaurants around here. When we first started culturing the sugar kelp, we had all of this extra. And so the next thing was to say, hey, local restaurants, you guys want to try it and see what you could come up with it. And the minute that product was available to them, they were so excited. This is great, it's fresh, it's local. In this day and age, it really helps with sort of promoting stewardship of your own coastline and in your own environment. And if you can do that and get a healthy snack out of it, is a good thing.